Ahora el padre Agustino nos va a dar una breve una breve para que nosotros podamos entender toda esta información en una manera más fácil, más like a summary, algo pequeño. Como un resumen, gracias, gracias. That's my sister. Un resumen, ¿ok? Resumen de que todas las cosas que hemos hablado hoy. So Father Agustino is going to give us a small summary of everything that's gone on.
We all here are for healthcare. We all want low cost and healthcare, but not at the price of our moral convictions. Amen. Not at the price of any life. And this is what we're talking about. Oh, you want this? I'll give you this, but you got to give me this. And like, there's some things that we will not give. So all those numbers that you saw, todos esos números que ustedes vieron, like seriously, like there is a risk, and the bishops have said that, you know, like, we are not going to compromise on this. Not now, not a year later. So it's not something that we need to figure out. We're figured out. Estamos pro salud. Queremos que todos tengan un aseguro de salud. I mean, I just came back from visiting my sister in Texas, and my sister had emergency surgery on her gallbladder. She doesn't have insurance. And you know what? Muchos de nosotros estamos en esas situaciones. No sabemos cómo vamos a cubrir ciertas cosas. But I don't care. I am not going to sacrifice what I hold to be true, what I know is true. Ever. And this is what we're talking about. Este es el problema. De que el gobierno está trabajando, está tratando de mandar lo que nosotros creemos. It's like, you know, you have a freedom of religion, and then the government has said, okay, you can believe what you want to believe. You know what? I don't really care what you believe, but you're going to do this, even though it goes against what you believe. This is a problem. If I had a bowl of dog food right here, and I said, mija, you got to eat this. Eat up. You have to do it. I'm the government. Do it. There's a problem with that. There's a problem. You know, like, that dog food, o sea, eso no le conviene. You know, like, people say, well, what's your problem? It's just dog food. What's your problem? It's just contraception. You all need to get up with the times. Mis hermanos y hermanas en Cristo, lo que nosotros creemos, tenemos razones por lo que creemos. We have reasons for what we believe. And we've been saying a lot of information here, and there's a lot of things that are included of what we believe, but what we need to know and realize that there are reasons. Infórmate. Get informed. Preocúpate. Get concerned. Y anímate, muévate. Get involved. We need to do something. We need to get involved. Y esto va a afectar al mundo entero. This will affect the entire world because it starts with a little thing. And then what else? Like they were saying, what is next? I don't know, but I was reading the rest of the Affordable Health Care Act, and this isn't it. Viene más. Y como es, it's like things are growing more and more, and I'm thinking, well, hold on. I was a history major in college, and algo huele mal. Something does not smell right. I mean, this is a history lesson. This is nothing new. Government has come in to the internal life of the church in many different countries. In countries, Father Isaac was talking about China in the homily. And the Chinese government, no judgment on their characters. I don't know what goes on in their conscience. But what the Chinese government is doing with the Catholic Church is wrong. Punto. What's been going on in other different countries about this lack of freedom of religion is wrong. Punto. I mean, hey, even my forefathers, my grandmother's generation in Mexico, it was basically, they were lining up priests. Father over here, Father Miguel Ángel, is from Spain. Not too long ago, they were just lining up priests and they were shooting them dead. There's something, I'm not saying that this is where they're going, and they would never say, well, we're not for that. I'm not saying that this is where our government is going, but we need to understand that if we don't stand up for what is ours, it can be taken away. If you don't understand that this is yours and you are being forced to do something that goes against what you believe, y'all need to stand up. You need to stand up. We need to get organized. We need to talk about this. We need to understand this. We need to get informed, get concerned, and get involved. This is important. Our generation is going to be judged by what happens in these coming years. I'm convinced of it. Y nosotros como católicos, nosotros como jóvenes, young adults, we are the ones that can move. We are the ones that can get some of these things going. And I don't know if you guys have ever been involved in anything like this. I don't know. Me, I come from a long line of activists. I'm just activists for the right man now.
Amen.
Things to remember. Get informed. Then things are changing very quickly. Get connected. We're gonna start these groups so that we can continue to get all the information that we need and make sure it's the right information. That's very important. Vale más que sea la información correcta. Eso es importantísimo. And then I don't know. We're gonna talk about other things that we're gonna do. We have a video that we've been preparing. It's not downloaded yet. Eliana's going to talk about what we're going to do, then we're going to do questions. Okay, we're still downloading the video that we have, that we're trying to put together, so I'm going to pass it on to Eliana, y luego después vamos a ver cómo está el video, y luego sus preguntas.
Okay, ¿quién aquí está motivado? Como que esto no está bien, como que hay que hacer algo, because this is irking me. I don't know about you, but I gotta do something. Like, I gotta stand on the chair and say no or something. Like, I don't know, you know? I wanna go outside and burn a bra. If you're from the 70s, you know what I'm talking about, okay? Okay, but we ain't burning bras because we met Jesus. Amen. Okay, ahora. No, porque hay que motivarse. Okay. Ahora, yo le voy a hablar a usted de qué, porque en la mente de nosotros, que okay, toda esta información, qué está pasando, todo eso, pero qué hacemos. What do we do about this? I tell you what you do. Okay, primordialmente, the first thing that you have to do, primera cosa que tú tienes que hacer, es sacar de tu mente que la pastilla de anticoncepción está bien. The first thing you have to do is take out from your mind that using the pill for any woman is acceptable, is okay, is something that we need. Because guess what? We have a perfect God, a God who does not make mistakes, and our body as women does everything for us. Okay? Tienes que aceptar eso. Acepta la doctrina. Acepta la doctrina. Because if you don't accept it, then guess what? Anybody that comes up to you and tells you, oh, but you know, I have this problem. You know, I need the pill. I'm sorry, pero mi iglesia me dice que yo soy creada perfectamente. Primera cosa que tienes que hacer. Then, this, I like to call this my hamburger tactic. They understand what I'm talking about. My hamburger tactic. It kind of goes like this. So I go to a restaurant with my coworkers or with my friends, and she's like, man, this, like, she's like opening her hamburger, and I go, hey, that hamburger looks so good. Did you hear about Obama's HHEC or whatever mandate? Did you hear about that? And then, you know, we'll start talking about the ketchup, but end up talking about Obama and the mandate. See where I'm going with this? It's called the hamburger method, because everywhere you go and everything you do and anybody that you meet, you talk about the HHS mandate. Everywhere you go. Because we all know that the best way to get something started is word of mouth. Word of mouth. Catholic, agnostic, atheist, does not matter. As Father was saying, this is about our conscience, our freedom of conscience. Okay? This is beyond religion right now. Okay? Entonces, para la traducción. Este, mi método se llama el método del chimichurri. Okay? Si yo voy con mis amigas para chimispa, ¿usted sabe lo que yo estoy diciendo? Oh, mira, este chimita, bueno, tú oíste lo que mamá quiere hacer. Dije que nosotros tenemos que pagarle la pastilla, tal y tal cosa. No, vamos a informarlo. ¿Tú quieres la biblioteca? Vamos. No, I have this. And always, siempre tener un artículo de periódico que de repente se te cae del bolsillo y tú lo vas a leer con alguien, you know. Randomly have newspaper articles with you that people read, you know. Things like that. What I'm trying to let you know is, it's simple. Don't be scared by how big the issue is or what's going on. Make it part of your daily conversation. Que esto sea parte de tu conversación diaria con cualquier persona, con tus amigos, con los sacerdotes, con tus hermanos, con tus padres, con todo el mundo. Que esto sea parte de tu conversación. Ahora, algo un poco más radical. Si tú tienes amigas que están usando la pastilla, ¿por qué no darle un papel con todos los efectos secundarios? No digas nada. El santo Saint Francis of Assisi, San Francisco de Assisi, decía, predicar el evangelio a todo el tiempo, y si tienes que hablar, habla. ¿Qué significa eso? Simplemente, dale eso. If you have a friend who is using the pill or any kind of contraceptive method, give her a paper with the list of 40 pages for Yaz, right? Yaz has 40 pages, 45 pages. Okay, a secondary, some people don't even like to read, 45 pages of what this pill can do to you. Now, another thing that you can do. If you are a woman who is sitting here today, and you are using the pill because of medical reasons, or because somebody fed into your mind that this is good for you, stop using it. Stop using it. Just boycott it. Do your silent boycott, your silent protest. Stop using it. Si tú eres una mujer que está aquí sentada hoy en este día y estás usando la pastilla de anticoncepción, deja de usarla. Que esa sea tu protesta. Que esa sea tu oración, tu sacrificio para la cuaresma. No la uses. Deja eso a un lado. Okay. Ahora, si tú eres parte de un grupo de jóvenes, si eres parte de un ministerio, si eres parte de los ujieres, de los lectores, de cualquier cosa en tu iglesia, infórmalos. Inform them of what is happening. Okay? Like Father said, inform yourself, because if you inform yourself, then you can inform others. And ¿quién aquí piensa que él no hace una, que él no puede hacer diferencia? Who thinks that their word, whatever they do, doesn't make a difference? Nobody, right? So you can make a difference. When you wake up in the morning and you look yourself in the mirror, say, I'm going to make the change.
Amen.
I'm going to make the change. Yo no voy a esperar que nadie haga el cambio, porque yo voy a hacer el cambio. Comencemos con las cosas pequeñas. Tu grano de sal, junto con mi grano de sal, junto con el grano de sal de ella, el de ella, el de ella y el de ella. Eso va a ser una montaña más grande que el Himalaya. Who is gonna, who, come on now, people. All right? So what I'm saying is, let's unite. Let's unite in prayer. Let's unite in conversation. Let's unite in information. Let's get together, because together we can do this. Amen?
Amen.
Juntos podemos hacer estos. Juntos en información. Juntos en oración. Juntos en ayuno podemos hacer esto. This is in our hands. Creamos en la doctrina de la Iglesia Católica. Porque obviamente lo que ellos nos están dando no nos está ayudando. Can I get an amen?
Amen. Amen.
All right. So let's do this, my people. Now we're going to see. Vamos a. Mm-hmm. Okay. We can do that. Okay. Ahora lo que vamos a hacer. Okay. Ahora lo que vamos a hacer es que, por si acaso, usted todavía no está segura de que Dios es un Dios perfecto y creó a la mujer con tanto detalle que nosotros no necesitamos nada de esos pepere que ellos nos dan. That's Dominican for stuff, right? We don't need any of that stuff that they're giving us. Holly is going to give an explanation and show a slideshow of the human, of the women's reproductive system. So ella nos va a enseñar unas fotos que se mueven del sistema reproductivo de la mujer.
Real quick, this is a quick biology lesson. Just gonna explain real quickly how the birth control pill works. And it's really important because we talk about the language. We need to listen to the language that we're being taught, because we're talking about contraceptives. Contraceptive means against life. Contraceptives. But usually a contraceptive is something that I take before I have relations to prevent getting pregnant, right? Contraceptive. Does anybody, how many people have heard of the term emergency contraception? All right, what do I mean by emergency contraception? Day after pill, plan B, that by the way is now being sold in vending machines on college campuses. True story. Now this is interesting because it's called contraception. But plan B is for a person who I already had intercourse and I think I'm pregnant. And now I'm going to try to go prevent what I already just did. How does that work? After the fact, but we're still calling it contraception. So because it's called contraception, I think that it's okay. Well, here's the thing. Plan B is only a higher dose of the birth control pill. It's just 4 times stronger. It's the same medicine. And in fact, really works in the same way. And all this information you can find in the prescription for the pill. If you open it up, it's a huge long thing in tiny, tiny writing. And it tells you exactly how it works, but hardly anybody reads it. It's also in the physician's desktop reference. So I'm going to talk real quickly. This is a woman's reproductive system. This is her ovaries. Once a month, she releases an egg into the fallopian tube. If she has intercourse, the sperm goes up through the uterus into the fallopian tube and meets the egg, and we call that fertilization or conception. Here's something crazy. In less than 1 second from the moment that the sperm meets the egg, in less than 1 second, all of your genetic information was already determined. The color of your eyes, the color of your hair, the sex of the child, the unique fingerprints that no one has ever had and no one ever will have, is already determined, geneticists have found, in less than 1 second. And within 24 hours, the cells are already dividing into skin cells and hair cells, eye cells. It takes 8 to 10 days for this new fertilized egg, this baby, to travel down the fallopian tube into the uterus and attach onto the uterine wall. And then it starts receiving nutrients from mom, and she gets weird cravings like pickles and ice cream and stuff, because baby needs all kinds of stuff. Okay? That's called implantation, when the baby implants. Now here's the thing. In 1976, the American College of Gynecologists and Obstetricians decided to change the definition of the word conception. They just said, we're going to redefine conception. It used to be, prior to 1976, that conception and fertilization were the same thing. In 1976, they said, no, we're going to define conception as implantation. Once it's implanted, then it's conception. So according to them, you didn't exist for 8 to 10 days. Why? Because they want to sell contraceptives. Here's how it works. The birth control pill and all these other contraceptives, chemical contraceptives, works in 3 ways. First, it tricks the woman's brain into thinking she's pregnant. If she's pregnant, the ovary will not release an egg. So if there's no egg and the sperm travels up there, Can she get pregnant?
No.
No. But sometimes there's what's called breakthrough ovulation and an egg is still released. So the second mechanism is that it changes the woman's structure so that it makes it difficult for the sperm to get up there. So if she has an egg released but there's no sperm, can she get pregnant? No. So these two ways are really preventative. But the third way that the birth control pill works, and the way that Plan B and all the emergency contraceptives work, is that it changes the lining of the uterine wall, and it makes it very thin and slippery. And so after that baby travels down and tries to attach onto that wall, it can't attach. And so the woman has her next period, and that new baby is flushed out in her period, and she has a very early abortion. But you see, the doctors and the gynecologists say, oh no, it's okay, it's not an abortion, because we changed the definition, and according to us, you weren't pregnant. So it's okay. See, they knew that most women wouldn't want to take these contraceptive medicines if they knew it was going to cause an abortion. So they changed the definition and made it impossible for the baby to implant, and she's having very early abortions. We have no idea how many abortions are caused by these chemical agents. But we're told, oh, Plan B, you're pregnant, just take this pill, it's a higher dose of medicine, and it's okay because we say you're not pregnant, and so you're not. If I say the world's flat, that doesn't make it flat. No doctor can tell us that we're not alive, even though for 8 to 10 days we're already traveling, dividing, all of our genetic material has already been determined. Just because they change that definition, they call it by a different name, doesn't change what it is. But most people don't know this information. And it's calculatedly kept in tiny print so that people will continue to buy it.
Thank you very much.